had this long-term experiment at Cedar Creek where we've been growing prairie grasses by themselves and then in various combinations. It's a biodiversity experiment. We're trying to find out, do changes in the number of species living in an ecosystem, which are changes in biological diversity, do those affect how that ecosystem functions? One of our species that we grew by itself as well as in mixtures was switchgrass. And switchgrass became famous as the energy grass of the future. But I kept looking at my experimental plots, and I have switchgrass growing in plots, and next to it I have a plot planted with 16 species, and I'd look at them, and the 16 species plots were always much, much more productive than switchgrass by itself, or than any of the things growing by themselves. We had 238% more energy produced on average in plots with 16 species, plots with biodiversity, compared to switchgrass growing by itself. A huge difference, a huge premium in yield and the energy you can get off an acre of land. And we can take advantage of the benefits of biological diversity on productivity, on stability, on storing more carbon in the soil and making the biofuel actually have a better greenhouse gas signature than if it wasn't grown in high diversity plots. Another thing we're trying to find out is how might we put let's say high diversity biofuel crops on a farmer's landscape. Are there some places where they actually do the farmer more good and society more good? We are finding out whether or not high diversity mixtures might be able to capture the nutrients that would say flow off a cornfield downslope or flow off a soybean field downslope. It might be able to capture those, causing the biofuel crop to actually give you higher yields because of those nutrients, but having them actually capture them in a way which keeps them out of the groundwater and keeps them out of lakes, rivers, and streams. If that's so, it might be that we'll go to a model of agriculture where you have some land that's a bit higher land that'll be farmed to soybeans and corn with a very large buffer strips around it of bioenergy crops, high diversity mixtures of species, say, which are then a sink that can absorb the nutrients, and we're even looking at whether they can absorb some of the pesticides or other chemicals that come off of agricultural landscapes. These are sort of off-the-wall ideas. They may work, they may not work, but we're trying to find out if there can be some synergy, some ways that we can sort of make a landscape that can provide us with a whole variety of benefits.